in the children's church. Like, they're all going to be in the children's church.
Captain. Marcus Bet. Just got back from Martin Beyond. Came here, thought I could get coffee. There was no one else there to serve coffee, so I need someone to serve coffee.
That's right, Dr. Speck. We just came back and we all really need coffee. From everyone here at the Starship Blacktown, we'd like to thank you for making this journey possible.
Thank you. All right, I would like to invite our liners to come up. These are our 3, 4, and 5-year-olds that have not completed kindergarten yet.
Many people that helped with the Limers this year for VBS. It takes a village, y'all. But they are 3, 4, and 5 years old. They've not gone to school yet, but we believe that they still need to learn about Jesus too, and they can learn so much. We have 3 that are morning people, but we technically had 27 3, 4, and 5-year-olds that came to VBS. So they are joining us now, and we're going to talk to them about some of the things that they liked the best. We're going to save a lot of the Bible story stuff for the older kids, but we're going to talk about what they really enjoyed while they were there.
So, Abby, do you want to come tell them what your 2 favorite stories were?
We can set one.
The Good Samaritan.
Good. She loved the Good Samaritan, and then she also told me that she loved learning about what the man that had what that Jesus had. What did we have? She liked learning about the man of leprosy. How many of you like our first story, Daniel and the Lions? Do you like Daniel and the Lions? But they did such a great job, and we truly enjoy having them. Like I said, we had 27 out of, I think, around 100 kids. 27 of those were 3, 4, 5 years. So we are really proud of all the kids. They're going to share one song with you that is awesome. So bear with us.
Thank you.
now I would like to invite our kids that were finished kindergarten all the way to fifth grade. If you guys would come on up. And as they come up, we're going to sing our theme song. Maybe. All right, if you know this song and you want to do the motions, you can stand up and do the motions with us. Come on, guys, I can't hear you. Welcome, friends, to Mars and Beyond, where we explore where God's power can take us. My name is Mission Commander Sean, and this is my friend and assistant, EP320.
Hi, everyone. Thank you for allowing your Voyagers to join us for VBS. We've had a great time learning new things together.
We sure have. What was your favorite part, EP320?
Favorite, as in only one? That's hard to decide. Maybe when you let me practice being the mission commander in session 2, or maybe watching the meteor shower with you in session 5. Oh, I know. My favorite part was sharing jokes with you in session 3. Can I share some with our Voyagers now?
Only if we have the time for that. But we've got a lot to report, so maybe later.
Okay. Well, I loved learning and sharing our Vectorverse each night. Can we do that now?
Oh, that's a good one. Our Vectorverse is the inspiration for everything we do here on the Mars and Beyond Outpost. It's Ephesians 3:20. Now I want everybody to stand up. And it is on the screen. We're going to count 1, 2, 3. Glory to God who is able to do far beyond all that we could ask or imagine, and his power at work within us. Ephesians 3:20.
Hey, Mission Commander Sean, you know what's better than saying our vector verse?
What's that, EP320?
Singing it. Can we do our vector verse song to help all our new Voyagers learn it?
That's a great idea. Chief Musical Officer Angie, will you help us do that?
I just love that song. And speaking of songs, do you know what kind of songs planets like to sing?
No, and I'm afraid to ask.
Neptune's, ha ha ha. You see what I did there?
Oh my goodness, yes, I see that. Along with our vector verse, Voyagers also learn Bible stories and memorize power launchers. Our power launchers are key learning phrases that help us remember where God's power can take us on our journey with Him. But don't take my word for it. Let's hear from some of our Voyagers and volunteers.
Katie.
Jealous of Daniel created a trap to get Daniel in trouble if he prayed to God. Daniel prayed anyways because he had faith in God. Even though it meant he would be thrown into a den of lions, Daniel trusted God to take care of him, and God did.
That's why our power launcher for session one is Go Beyond with Faith. Let me hear you repeat that with me.
Go Beyond with Faith.
Great job, thank you.
Yeah.
Our Bible story for session two came from the Old Testament, Book of Esther, chapter 4 through 9, and it told us about Queen Esther. Queen Esther's people were in danger, and she was the only person in the kingdom with the possession and resources to help them.
In those days, approaching the king without permission could cost a person his or her life. Queen Esther had to be bold and to meet with the king anyway, to stand up for her people. When she did, the king listened to her, and her people were saved. Because of our faith, we can be bold like Queen Esther to use our position and our resources to stand up for others too. That is why our power launcher for this session is Go Beyond with Boldness. Say that with me.
Go Beyond with Boldness.
Behind me.
Jordan. We get very busy or excited or worried sometimes, but Jesus shows us that it is a special blessing when we remember to pause and say thanks to God. That's why our power launch for session four is Go Beyond with Thankfulness. And y'all know what to do.
Go beyond with thankfulness. Speaking of being thankful, we had three of our team that was stuck in a broken starship, the Starship Galaxian. And the Voyagers were vital in helping to send the necessary fuel cells to get them back to the Mars outpost. Now we are going to welcome them back and allow them to share a little bit with us.
Hey everyone, we're back. Did you miss us? Thank you for rescuing us.
I see a lot of people here who don't know who we are.
Maybe we should reintroduce ourselves.
I'm Lieutenant McFrazzle, and I love chocolate. And to my left here is Dr. Speck, who, as you can see, is a little caught up in his crossword puzzle.
And I'm Captain Tubion. I'm the captain of the Starship Galaxian.
We were on a mission to explore far beyond our solar system. But if you were here this week, you saw we got stranded.
But thanks to you guys, you rescued us, and now we're back.
Hey, do you guys know a five-letter word that means seeing without sight?
Oh, I know. It's faith. That was the first element that the Voyagers gave us.
Yeah, after the first night, the Voyagers really showed me what it's like to have faith in God.
Yeah, they really did.
Sorry to interrupt, but do you guys know an eight-letter word that means willingness to take a risk and act with courage?
Well, before you rudely interrupted me, I was going to talk about boldness.
That's right. That was our second fuel cell we needed. God can help us be bold in our faith and proclaim his name to everyone we meet.
Yeah, that reminds me of the time we thought we were actual superheroes. Space really messed with our minds.
Not as much as it did with Dr. Speck. As soon as we ran out of coffee up there, he went crazy. Remember the time he thought he was an actual ukulele player?
Oh yeah, I still have a headache from that day. Dr. Speck, did the word boldness fit?
Yes, Lieutenant. Captain, do you know an eight-letter word that means being friendly, generous, and considerate?
Yes, I do, Doctor.
Oh, I know. It's kindness.
Lieutenant, he asked me. That wasn't very kind of you to cut me off.
Well, I shouldn't have interrupted you. I'm sorry. But it reminded me of something that we learned. God tells us to always be kind to everyone. Do you guys both know the golden rule? Really? It's treat others how you would want to be treated. Which basically is just saying we should always treat others with kindness because that's how we would want them to treat us.
You're right, Lieutenant. Now remember, thank you. Dr. Speck, did that complete your crossword puzzle?
Well, it did for that word, and now I need a 12-letter word that means the feeling of being happy and grateful because of something.
I can help you with that one. Lieutenant, do you remember what our fourth fuel cell was? Really? It was thankfulness. Space really messed with your head.
Oh, now I remember. I'm so thankful you helped me. Oh, so funny.
You certainly are, Lieutenant.
Oh, man. I only have this very last word, and I'm not sure that I know what it is. Could you guys help me one last time?
Sure.
What is a four-letter word that means wanting for something to happen?
Oh, I know what it is. It's hope. That's what we had when the Voyagers were helping us. We'd hoped that they would find all five fuel cells and help us return home.
Yeah, while we were stranded up there, I was just hoping that when we got home, we could have a lot of chocolate. And guess what? We did.
Lieutenant, I'm so glad that you finally got chocolate. But, Dr. Speck, did that complete your crossword puzzle?
Yes, Captain. Completely done.
Great. Oh, would you look at the time? Oh, goodness, we're going to be late.
To what?
We forgot to turn our research into our boss.
Oh, no.
I'm so sorry, guys, but we really don't want to get in trouble. We got to go. Bye.
All right, Grace family, you've been sitting way too long, so I need everybody to stand up. This one has a little bit of motions. The motions will be on the screen.
Or you can watch the kids.
Or you can watch the kids. Don't make me call you out. Russ Russell.
Thank you.
the moon. All right, we're going to go to the left. Tiny, tiny. To the front. One, two, three, four. Tiny, tiny. One, two, three, four. Look back, but you better look back. One, two, three. Okay, we're gonna do it again. Take four steps to the left, to the left. One, two, three, four. Come and move to the right. One, two, three, four. Tiny, tiny. To the front. One, two, three, four. Look back. One, two, three, four. Everybody clap your hands.
Good job.
That was great. Some of you are a little rusty. Come back for second service. We're going to do it again now that you know the motions.
Don't scare them.
This week, our kids had missions to raise money for Lincoln Homes Wednesday night meals and collect backpacks for the children of Lincoln Homes. And your Grace kids did an outstanding job. Throughout the week, they raised $965.42 and collected 114 backpacks. We are so proud of them. And since they did such a great job, on August the 10th, we're going to have a VBS celebration. We're going to have a pizza party, a water slide, and snow cones from 11 to 2. So make sure you come back and bring your swimsuits and towels. At this time, we're going to take an offering. Will, there he is.
Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for this amazing day that you've given us. We just ask that you would just take this offering, Lord, that you would bless it. God, thank you for the hands that gave it and for the work that it will do in this church and that your name would be magnified in it. And it's in your precious name I pray, and everybody said.
And if you feel like you can sit down during this song, great. If not, stand up and do it with us.
Defend me so I
And speaking of celebrations, we are very, very excited to announce that 13 children decided to follow Jesus for the rest of their life this week.
That was my favorite part of VBS. Thanks to all of you who had a part in helping for VBS. It takes so many people to make a complete success. We are truly blessed to have such an awesome church family willing to pour your time and love into our children.
We hope you had as much fun as we did, and that you remember to explore where God's power can take you every day. Now, VBS is not quite over yet. At 2 o'clock today, we'll be meeting to take down, because Pastor, although he loves the space station, wants the stage to be put back and all the rooms to be put back in order. So we'll be meeting today at 2 o'clock to take down all the decorations. And we could use some help, please. Now I'd like to invite Pastor Rich to come up.
I was wondering, were you waving at me all morning or your mom and dad behind me? Yeah, I figured. Folks, a few things before we close today. First of all, we want to thank everybody that worked this week. So if you brought Kool-Aid pouches, if you worked one of the rooms, if you did a Bible story, if you worked the zip line, if you were a teenager or an adult helper this week, would you stand up, please? Registration, parking, all that stuff. Thank you very much. You can be seated. It takes an army of folks to do something like this. Sometimes people say, Pastor Rich, how'd you become a pastor? It was so that I didn't have to lead VBS, because this would have terrified me. But we want to say to Pastor Rochelle, Rochelle, we know that you throw your heart into the summer specifically, and camps and VBS, and we are very thankful for you and the work that you do. So. And please come this afternoon and help tear down. If you are visiting with us today, if this isn't your normal place that you go and worship, if you're our guest today because your kids were part of Vacation Bible School, let me take this opportunity to invite you back. If you have a church home that you attend regularly, if you go there and that's your church home, then we want to say bless you in your church home. And if you don't have a place where you go, we would love to invite you back. We'll be here next week, and we'd love to have you back. We have two services every Sunday morning at 9:30 and at 11, and we would love to have you come back and visit us. You're always welcome here. We had three anniversary offerings. We collect or people give an anniversary offering when they celebrate wedding anniversaries, and I can't read things anymore, so I use my glasses. And I wanted to recognize those. Mike and Lindsay Caldwell have been married 15 years. Rich and Dana Cook, if they can hang in there until Wednesday, will have been married 26 years. And Miss Louise, in honor of her husband, who has gone on to eternity, wanted to recognize their what would have been 68th wedding anniversary. So thank you, Miss Louise Glass. We're going to pray this morning before we go. This morning, I believe, Billy Spillers fell. What time did he fall? Early this morning. Okay. So Billy fell this morning, and they are fearing that he has broken his neck. So he was here with our kids earlier in the week. He was working VBS. And would you all pray with me for Billy and for Beth Spillers? We also want to pray for Willie Mullins, who had surgery this week. He was in the hospital most of the week, is now home. Let's keep praying for Willie. Teresa Carpenter is also home. She was back in the hospital this week. Teresa McPherson is home. That's Kim Slight's mother, that's Gerald's wife, Miss McPherson, is now home from rehab after back surgery. Let's keep praying for Gloria Hodges and Gerard Caldwell, that's Mike's brother. But would you bow your heads? Let's pray together this morning. God, we thank you that we have a church, a family. And God, we thank you for this particular place, Grace Church of the Nazarene. God, we thank you for this place, but we recognize that we are part of the family of God that stretches around the globe. God, thank you for this place. Thank you, God, that we've seen this morning that your word still speaks and that your church still loves kids. We are following our leader in that. Jesus said, "Let the children come to me." And the kingdom belongs to such as these. And that children will lead us. And they've led us this morning in praise and in energy. God, we thank you for a church that loves and values kids and families. God, would that always be the case here and in every other church around Clarksville, around the world? God, you've heard our needs this morning, the very specific physical needs that people are facing and going through right now. God, we pray for Billy specifically right now that you would touch his body as he's in intensive care. God, give the doctors and nurses wisdom to know what to do. And mostly, Lord, we just pray your healing hand would be on him. Jesus, we pray that in your name. God, for the seeds that have been planted this week through Vacation Bible School, through the tons of kids that have been in and out of our property, through the Bible stories that they have heard, and through the kids that have chosen this week to put their trust in you, and one this morning and second service that will be baptized. God, we praise you for the seeds that you have planted. God, we pray that every one of those seeds would bear much fruit. And someday, God, that these kids would lead our church, that these kids would show our church what it means to follow Jesus. God, we pray that you would bear much fruit in the young and in the older. We thank you, God, for a church family. We pray, God, your blessing on the remainder of this service, and we give you praise. In your great name we pray. Amen. Am I doing anything else, or are you doing anything else? Are you closing? We should have had this conversation earlier.
Your life is correct. You have a video of pictures to show.
Kids, okay, if you go on back to the children's church, and then while you go back, your parents are going to watch what fun you had at VBS this week. So go on back to the children's church. You can watch the video during second service.
Thank you.
Thanks again to everybody who...
I didn't touch it.
Sean didn't touch it, he said. Thanks again to everybody who worked this week. I want to read one of the stories that the kids closed the week with, and then we'll close this morning. But I wanted everybody to hear this story. It's a story that we forget a lot about Jesus after Jesus' crucifixion and his resurrection, and after Jesus appears at the empty tomb, and when he shows himself to the disciples, when he shows himself to the women who came on that Sunday morning. This is a story that we often forget to tell, but it's found in Luke chapter 24. You've already stood up this morning, so I'll let you keep your seat. But I want to read this to you this morning from Luke chapter 24. Now that same day, this is Resurrection Sunday. That same day, two of the disciples were going to the village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem. They were just going home after all of the happenings during the Passover celebration in Jerusalem. They were talking with each other about everything that had happened, and as they talked and discussed these things with each other, Jesus himself came up and walked along with them. But they were kept from recognizing him. He asked them, "What are you discussing together as you walk along?" Which proves that Jesus asked loaded questions. They stood still, their faces downcast. One of them, named Cleopas, asked him, "Are you the only one visiting Jerusalem who doesn't know about the things that have happened in these days?" "What things?" Jesus asks. Loaded question. "About Jesus of Nazareth," they replied. "He was a prophet, powerful in word and deed before God and all the people. The chief priests and our rulers handed him over to the Romans to be sentenced to death, and they crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one who was going to redeem Israel. And what is more, it's the third day since all this took place. In addition, some of our women amazed us. They went to the tomb early this morning, but they didn't find his body. They came and told us that they had seen a vision of angels who said that he was alive. Then some of our companions went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they did not see Jesus. Jesus said to them, 'How foolish you are, and how slow to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Did not the Messiah have to suffer these things and then enter his glory?' And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he explained to them what had been said in scriptures concerning himself. As they were approaching the village to which they were going, Jesus continued on as if he was going further, but they urged him strongly, 'Stay with us, for it is nearly evening and the day is over.' So he stayed with them. And when he was at the table, he took bread and he gave thanks. He broke it and he gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened and they recognized that that was Jesus. And he disappeared from their sight. They said to each other, 'Were not our hearts warmed and stirred within us as he talked with us on the road and he opened the scriptures to us?'" The story here that I want us to close with and take away is this, that even after the crucifixion, even after the darkness, even after what would have been for a follower of Jesus, the lowest, the worst, the most hopeless time in their lives, even then, it wasn't just information. It wasn't just a story that Jesus sent these men. He actually came and showed up in their lives. He brought them hope. One of the elements that the kids had to find and track down to rescue our three teenage space travelers was hope. And that's still what he's bringing us and giving us today. We talk about hope here all the time because that's what Jesus talked about all the time. And if you could use some hope in the world that you live in, if you could use some hope, we'd love to invite you back. So please come and visit us again. Would you stand up? We're going to close this morning. We're very thankful that you came this week. We're very thankful that you spent this morning with us. Thanks for your kids and grandkids being part of VBS. We hope this morning's been a blessing. We'd love to invite you back. Would you bow your heads and pray with us? Jesus, we thank you. We know that you love us. We know, God, that all the things that you give us, one of the greatest is hope. And God, as we leave here, as we go on about our Sunday, as we begin a new week, God, we pray that the hope that you gave these men walking to Emmaus, the hope that you gave the early church when you showed up, that same hope can be evidenced in us. That you would bring us not just stories about hope, not just activities with others or interactions with others, but Jesus, that you would show yourself to be true and alive and at work today by showing up in us. God, bless us with the hope found in Jesus. We pray these things in your powerful name. Amen. You're dismissed. Hey, shake hands with about 20 people as you go. We'd love to have you back. God bless you.